one of my favorite actors.
Oh, thank you.
I am so enamored to just speak with you today.
Thank you.
My first question is this. Now, there's obviously so much chatter about the next Harold and Kumar. And while you did share an interview, there's no real updates.
Yeah.
What would you like to see with Harold and Kumar 4, you know, if we hopefully get that sequel?
I know everybody wants to know what the plot would be. Like, do we want to go to the moon? Do we want to go to... Everyone's got their own pitch, too, which I appreciate, right?
Yeah.
That means that people are invested. To me, the movie works because of the friendship between the two guys. You could literally send them anywhere.
Yeah.
They could do, or they don't even have to do anything. I mean, the first movie was literally about trying to get hamburgers. You know what
I
mean?
And I went to White Castle afterwards.
Right. So I think you could send them anywhere as long as that friendship story stays. And of course, it will. I'm not trying to dodge the question. I'm just saying, what's really special about the movies, you know, I would love to be 100 years old doing like the 10th movie, you know, because of how much I love the franchise. Also, that character is cooler than I will ever be in my life. So,
I don't know. That's debatable because you're pretty cool to me.
Thank you.
Now, you know, you dress the part, you play the part. That's what Snoop Dogg's character Jay just said in the film. Now, if you could dress for your next ideal role, what would you dress like and what would it be?
It's a tough one to... Oh, well, no, it's easy, actually.
Okay.
I'm a huge astronomy nerd. I'd love to play an astronaut. So, like... full astronaut outfit.
Would you go to the moon or would you go to another planet?
I'm a little obsessed with the ISS right now, so maybe space station.
Okay.
But other planet would be cool.
I love that.
Yeah.
Now, you know, who would you say is an underdog in your industry right now that you're rooting for?
Oh, there are a lot. Yeah. I think what's interesting about this question, I'm not going to get like too sappy about this, but you know, understandably, as there should be a lot of focus on diversity and representation, and I think a lot of us who have the chance to be in the public eye get asked about it a lot.
Yeah.
And the first people I think of course, the up-and-coming actors and people who I'm really excited for, but the people on whose shoulders I stand, who came a generation or two before me, you know, we won't know their names as household names because they never even had the opportunities that I've enjoyed. The opportunities I've enjoyed obviously are like nothing compared to this next generation of artists. So that's both what excites me and the people who I really want to give a shout out to.
I love that. Now, something that really resonated with me, and I want to just thank you for always being so open and vulnerable. In 2021, you know, you opened about your personal life and shared your journey to discovery of, you know, who you were and your orientation, etc. 2.5 years later, how has that journey been ever since? And what would you say to someone who may be on that same journey, you know, that's looking at you, looking for those kind of answers, that's going through it right now?
Yeah, thank you for the question. I mean, look, I'm really proud of, I think you're talking about the book that I wrote in 2021. Most of it was about how systems can and do change over time. It's a memoir. It's mostly like just sophomoric jokes because I wanted to make people laugh. The books that I really look towards are like... Mindy Kaling's books or Tina Fey,
really
Rainn Wilson. Like, these are books that I learned something from, but I could just take it to the pool and read. And so whether it was, you know, whether it was a story about auditions and kind of coming up as a performer of color in the early 2000s when there were very few roles for us, or whether it was a story about my partner Josh and I meeting unlikely through a NASCAR race.
Which I think is so fun. That part I loved.
It was fun. And so I think, look, you know, the stories that I was really happy to share with folks were my slice of life story. I would never want to speak for somebody else's experience, and I really appreciate how you worded the question, because I think, you know, everyone lives their own journey and figures their things out at the right time for them, and I'm really proud of my journey, and I wish everybody the best with theirs.
Now, my final question is this. I love watching you on The Daily Show.
Oh, thank you.
You are so good. The line of questioning, even how you just keep everyone on their toes. So, like, let's say they were like, hey, Cal, this is yours.
Yeah.
What would you say?
Yeah, hell yeah. They know that, though. I've put this out there. I would love to host The Daily Show permanently. I hope it's in the cards. You know, obviously they have a lot of incredible choices. If you look at the list of guest hosts, people who I am immense fans of and have a lot of respect for. That said, I also would like the job. So they got a tough choice to make. I hope I'm the guy they pick, but if not, I'm rooting for whoever gets the pick.
Well, I'm adding you to the top one.
Thank
so
you.
If anyone's voting for you, it's Ty Cole.
I appreciate it. Thank you.
Thank you so much,
Thank
Cal.
You. I appreciate it.